Hello everyone, welcome to my fifth lecture. I am here with one of the most important topics in Excel, the number formats. This will be required when you are preparing a sheet and want to share this with the upper management. There you need to check all the number formats, the date formats, whether the percentage are correct or not. So this lecture is going to help you a lot over here. And this will also solve a problem, like say, for example, if you want to record a number which is of 16 digits, 17 digits, how do you do that? So this is going to be pretty interesting. So without wasting much time, let's just share my screen and get into this, okay? This is the previous sheet which I have already been using. Okay, so yeah, now we have learned about clipboard, font, alignment. Now the turn is for number format. Okay, so if you go and see the number formats, the default is general, right? The default is general. Okay, so to calculate these are the lines reviewed, errors found. Now what will be the error percent over here? So you have learned in mathematics, the error percent is errors found divided by this, the lines reviewed. But this is not in the percentage, right? So if any colon is for percentage, what we need to do is we'll go here, okay? We will click on percentage. Now let's see what happens. 4 divided by 25, 16%, okay? Now, if you want to copy this formula, you have a lot of ways. Control C, just Control V, right? This is the formula. A shortcut, do this, Control D, right? So this is the percentage format, okay? This was into the percentage section. I have just explained you over here only. You can just go and copy this, okay? So this is the percentage format, okay? Now let's learn about currency and accounting as well. Suppose you are an HR and you need to prepare a salary sheet. This is not the actual salary sheet. It's just a dummy data. Okay, so you need to add the currency, right? Salary per month, 12,000, 13,000, what? $12,000, 12,000 euros. It's INR, right? So how you need to do is you go to this drop down. Check over here. Are you finding any currency? Yes, I am. See, I have done this, right? 12,000. If you want more decimal places, you can do this. Sorry, if you want more decimal places, you can do this. If you want no decimal places, you can do this. So these are the sections which helps in increasing the decimal places and decreasing the decimal places, right? Again, for the overtime, go over here, go to the currency section, okay? Do this. Right? Again, go over here, go to the currency section. Now let's try and see if the format printer works over here, right? The format printer works. So this is the magic of format printer, okay? Now I'll tell you the basic difference between the currency and the accounting. I'll explain it over here. I'll write 100, okay? And here as well, 100, right? Now let's see what is the difference between currency and accounting. Currency, and let's learn about accounting as well. Accounting. Did you see any difference? Like in the currency section, in the currency, if I just do this, see, I'll just do this. Okay. So for currency, the rupee symbol is very close to the number, right? But for the accounting, it is a bit far, right? It is left aligned. So whenever you are dealing with finance data, the total salary or any total is calculated in accounting, right? This is very important that you make sure that wherever you are calculating any total salary, keep it in the account format. Your manager will be impressed by you because he or she must know that, hey, they have the basic knowledge, right? So this is how the sheet now looks. Is it like now it looks presentable, right? So this we have learned about the percentage format, currency and accounting. Now let's move on to the date format. Okay, I have a like a resources name like Lokesh Kumar. Say for example the date of joining is I'm writing 15 Jan 2018, and then I'll be writing, say for example, a date of resignation is 25 September 2021. Okay, so if I need to know the number of days worked, right, how I'll do this, I'll select this is equals to, remember, each and every formula, just like mathematics in Excel, will be started by a equal sign, right? Date of resignation is this, date of joining is this. Now we have the number of days. See the number, it's in the number format. I'll just reduce the decimal places. I don't need this. Now what I'll do, I'll go over here. I'll again use the parenthesis, the brackets divided by 365. This is 4 years, right? Around 4 years. If you just do this, 3.70 years. Done. So these are the number of years. Earlier it was number of days. Now it is number of years. So for number of days, you do not need to divide it by 365. For number of years, you need to divide it by 365. Okay. Now, what date format actually is, right? Say for example, you are dealing with US clients. There the date format is different. Like here we are using DDMMYY. There you'll be having, I'm not sure, but maybe say for example, MMDDYY or YYMMDD. So how do you change those formats, right? You have short date. This is the short date. You have long date as well, right? You can do this. But if you want more formats, go to more number formats, right? And for the date section, right? Whatever way you want to write, say for example, if you want the years first, like YYY, MMDD, just click over here. If you want this, like say for example, I want this, right? So you can change the format as required. So this is the date format. See the magic of Format Painter. I keep on saying Format Painter is the strongest tool, is very strong when you talk about the basic Excel. So this is about the date format, right? Go to the more number formats, go to date, just look around. If you want this Wednesday, you can do this. If you want more formats, go to date, just click over here. Just do this 1403, 14 March, 14. These are the formats. You can click any format you want. Play around this, right? So this is date format, okay? Now, let's learn about the time format, okay? So for the time, what you need to do is, I have just used the formula, but I'll just delete this. I'll do this in front of you. Again, I have selected the in time for any resource, like say, for example, 9, I'll write it over here. For 9 a.m., I'm entering the office, 5 p.m., I'm going out of the office. How many hours did I work? 5 p.m. minus 9 a.m. Oops, do not worry at all. Just close into the brackets, multiply this by 24. Where is the multiply? Yeah. Now you see 12 a.m. Do not worry. See the format, it says custom. If you go over here and click on the number, you'll get the number of hours worked, right? If you do not want the decimal places, just do this. And this is it. Let me just do the center alignment. Now, if you just look at the formula bar, it says 17, right? You again don't need to worry. This is into the 24-hour format. So this is pretty fine. Now, this is how you find the time difference. This is how you find like the number of years worked, number of days worked, and you can play around the formats, the general format, number, currency, accounting, short date, long date, time, percentage. Now, one very, again, let me just do this just for a moment. How it is finding the difference? How it is finding the number of hours worked or the number of years worked. If you go over here and click on text, so this is how it looks, the dates. Now, if you just go and click on short date, this is how it looks, right? So this is about date. Again, as I told you in my introduction, that I'll let you know how you paste a data or how you record a data which is of more than 15 digits, right? Like say for example 1 2 3 4 5 6 give me a moment, 4. Clear? So you get a data of this format, right? You get a data of this format. Again, let's do this. 1 1 1 1 2 2 2 2 3 3 3 3 4 4 4 4, right? We have 4 4 8 4 12 4 16, right? The last digit is 4. Let's remember this. Now this is, where is my number? I don't know. So this is of the scientific format, right? This is of the scientific format. Now if you want to store this data, what you'll do, just go over here in the formula bar, record your last digit and give a single quotation, right? This is how the data is stored. Now if you click over here, just you can click on ignore error. This is how you record the larger numbers. And this will come when, say for example, a resource is working and he needs to copy and paste the IDs, right? So the IDs at times are pretty long. So this is how you store the IDs. So to sum it up, what we have learned, the number formats, how you check the percentage, what's the difference between currency and accounting, what's the different type of date formats, how you calculate the number of hours worked, and lastly how you record the data which is more than 15 digits, right? So this is what you have learned. Go and practice, and I'm sure this section will help you a lot. Okay, so stay tuned. The next lecture will be on conditional formatting. So please keep learning, be educated, and change the world. Thank you so much. Have a great day. Bye.